You too, what's the deal, man? Back with another one. We got your boy Elliot Green, My Career. We got a little plot twist for y'all, man. We'll get into some game action and take it from there, man. But as you can see, we're 77.5 points a game. We're about to assist. Coach about to see in the score. We're going to take a look at the rookie report, too. Rookie report, you got it. What's up? I'm going to highlight over this name, man. It's not so much of Melo. Melo don't really have a problem with us, man. But somebody on his squad is starting to make some noise because they thought coming into this situation that he was going to take over and, you know, we end up making the squad, so. You know what I'm saying? We're going to get into some gameplay action. And we're just going to go from there, man. This first game going to be simmed down a little bit for the storyline. I'll try to make the videos a little bit more towards the storyline. So we're going to do that, man, and let's get it. Yes, sir. We back again with the Brody. Elliot Green, baby. Let's get it. Man, y'all make sure y'all cherish this game, man. I don't know. Something might shake after this, man. So, y'all watch for a little, you know, little stuff here and there, man. I'm going to mute up. Let y'all enjoy the gameplay. Let's get it. Let's go. So I don't know if y'all seen this. I'm basically having to create my own offense. They're not really getting your boy in the rotation as far as the ball movement is concerned. It's a reason to that. Stay tuned, man. I don't know if y'all know this too, man. I usually be calling plays. I might call out the defense, call out the offense, stuff like that, bring up the ball. I'm not doing none of that. So it's a reason to it, man. Just stay tuned. All right, so you see, they took your boy out for the rest of the first quarter. They put me back in the second quarter. It's a specific person in attendance at this game, man, that's making some noise. It's been making some noise behind the scenes because they got interest of another player taking over this team. And now, like, I've been taking over, so. You're gonna see. All right, man. So the highlights play, man. Basically, what happened is, I'll give you a little backstory. LeVar Melo's dad wanted him to come in and take over the squad, bro. So basically, he thought that LaMelo was gonna come in and take over the team. Well, they know that the team had picked me up from playing a year overseas after I left North Carolina. Ended up getting picked up by the team, and Melo and both of us played in the G League. We played 5 games in the G League. They just wanted to get us acclimated to the offense and, you know, see how we did really move, because neither one of us had a lot of tape. So basically, man, after that, the coaches gave me the green light, and he's not been going off. Well, LeVar didn't like it, and he's been making noise about taking back money that he's invested in the organization, taking his son away from the organization, having his son flip on the organization, and things of that nature. So basically, man, coach comes and tells me this at halftime, and they give me the red light. Say, yo, we got to look out for the future of the franchise. You got to go to the bench. So, trade rumors are true, man. Your boy getting traded. But the front office is being, you know what I'm saying, more than cool with your boy. They're going to give me and my agent some time to work some stuff out. So, basically, I just come to them and let them know what trade I'm going to go through. So, let's get it.